Mosier. O'Keefe in the corner, sliding it behind the net. Missed everybody. Tanaka goes after it in the far corner, pinned up by Schwinard. And a minute remaining here in the second period with the Axemen down 2-1. Bona in his own end has to be careful. And McKinnon works him to the boards on the far side. And now Jezegu comes in to help out. Bona now gets it ahead, and Schwinard's going to be content to roll at the center. Backing up D'Orazio. Over to Tanaka on the left side. Tanaka looking for a pass. Sends across side. Hit Mosier. Puck is centered, and Schwinard is there to intercept. Another rookie forward comes out. Looks at the clock and then goes to center and bounces it in. LeBerge after it along with D'Orazio. They bump down below the goal line of the St. Mary's zone. Owens pinching down low on the far side. Shovels it to the corner. O'Keefe is there. O'Keefe slides it ahead to Bloodoff. Bloodoff up on the left side over the Acadia line. Less than 10 seconds to go. Bloodoff to the goal line. Hit to the boards by Helas, but stays with the puck. Bloodoff works the boards. Goes to the corner. Centers out in front. Cuthbert wide. He shoots and the buzzer sounds. And that's going to end it for period number two. All the scoring was in the first period. No scoring in that second period. Maybe a slight bit more life in that second period than the first, Travis, but nonetheless, it has been a strange game with just 26 shots on goal altogether here tonight.
Yeah, I mean, I think, you know, maybe a little better that period, but I don't think, again, I mean, I don't think either team was very good at all, and, you know, hopefully, you know, for our sake, that we can, you know, crank it up here for 20 minutes in the third and find a way to come out with 2 points here tonight.
All right, coming up on our second emission, lots, including scores out of town. You're listening to the Leon's Furniture March of Champions on ABR.
He was the head coach that never was. We'll tell you that story after a word from Joe's Food Emporium in Wolfville.
How about a treat for your taste buds with something special from Joe's Food Emporium, including the new Lebanese menu, the great pizza, and more. Or stop in and enjoy the sports bar. Whether you're trying to catch your favorite sport or team, you can watch it on one of the 15 TVs at Joe's. And don't forget to book your Christmas party with friends or for the office. Joe's is the place to call. Joe's Food Emporium, where great food and great friends come together. Main Street, Wolfville, 542-3033.
Big John Huer took over as head coach of the football Axemen in 1979 and promptly guided them to the university's first ever Vanier Cup championship. Not one to sit back and be content with success, Huer fashioned an Axemen team 2 years later that won Acadia's second Vanier Cup. He made the decision to leave Acadia and take the head coaching job with the CFL expansion Atlantic Schooners. Unfortunately for Coach Huer, the team never got off the ground and he became the coach of a team that never was. Before his coaching successes at Acadia, John Huer had a very impressive career as a player. After an outstanding college career with the University of Maine, Huer played 3 seasons with the Denver Broncos in the NFL, another with New Orleans, and a couple of seasons with Montreal and Toronto in the CFL. Huer is now the CEO of Northeast Turf in Maine, and his generous donation to Acadia made the recent upgrade and installation of field turf to Raymond Field possible. Coach John Huer is a member of the Acadia Sports Hall of Fame.
You've been listening to Speaking of Sports, an Acadia Sports Heritage Moment with Stan Cameron.
Where does Santa practice sliding down chimneys? The gymnasium.
Ho, ho, ho.
Yes, Leon's Ho, Ho, Hold the Payments event is on now, and it just got better. Right now, you can get a comfy reclining sofa for just $299 when you purchase a matching love seat and chair, and deliveries included. And you can pay absolutely nothing, not even the taxes, for 18 months with no interest. Leon's Ho, Ho, Hold the Payments event. Now even better. Merry Christmas, Canada.
Spend the holidays in hot water. Holland Home Leisure presents their 2011 Hot Tub Clear Out. Score a sweet deal on a new Beachcomber, the energy-efficient hot tub that's made in Canada for our Canadian climate. On top of huge discounts, you'll receive a bonus prepaid Visa valued at up to $1,000, plus half-price hot tub accessories, stress relief, and prepaid plastic. Just in time for the holidays. Sail on now at Holland Home Leisure, New Minas and Aylesford, because life's better when you're wet.
Add a festive touch to your Christmas celebrations with Rayfuse Home Hardware Building Center. Drop by for a great selection of decorations. From LED lights to Christmas ornaments, tree stands to tinsel, you'll find all the trimmings for a beautiful holiday season. And when you're looking for great gift ideas, see Rayfuse selection of Yankee candles, cookware, and more. Happy holidays from Rayfuse Home Hardware Building Center, Wolfville.
Homeowners, helping homeowners.
The choice is yours. Choose Ford and choose your offer. At Valley Ford, get up to $8,500 in manufacturer rebates from December 1st through 15th or 0% APR financing from December 16th to 30th on most new 2011-2012 models. Certain date restrictions apply. Offers not available at the same time. And for a limited time at Valley Ford, all remaining 2011 models receive up to $2,500 in Christmas cash over and above all current programs. Valley Ford, Kentville. Valley Ford, where else?
Welcome back to the second intermission of Voice from the Past, a gentleman we've had on our broadcast when he was a player with the St. Mary's Huskies, a former captain, and of course he was also an assistant coach with the Acadia Axemen, and now finds himself behind the bench as an assistant coach with the Halifax Mooseheads, Jim Midgley. Jim, thanks for your time.
Thanks for having me.
Well, you've been gone from Acadia for several years out of the university scene, but you're somewhat geographically close to home, to St. Mary's in Acadia. How did you land the job with the Halifax Mooseheads?
Well, to be honest with you, it was something that always interested me to get back into major junior hockey. And, after two years in St. John, it was a great experience working at that level. I played at that level, but coaching at that level really excited me, and I really enjoyed my 2 years there. And it was sort of having a little bit of a relationship with Cam Russell, and he had approached me during the summer months, and we had sort of chit-chatted about it, and it just sort of came together, a few weeks after that, after meeting Coach Dominic Ducharme here. So it sort of just came together awful quick, and I, like I said, I really enjoyed the league, and it was a good fit, and I sort of came in at the right time with the excitement with the organization.
Yeah, no question. We'll talk about that here in a moment. I do want to ask you, because no better person to ask, because you've played university hockey, you've coached it, now you're with a major junior team. And I don't know if people really realize this, that don't go to both brands of hockey, but there is a huge difference when you make that step from major A to university, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a big change. Coming back, taking a step back, working with younger kids, and that's the biggest thing that I see not in terms of age, but most of all in terms of development. And you have kids coming right from midget programs and prep school programs, and it's a whole new experience for these kids living with a billet family and going to a different school. And the French kids coming to an English community, so there's lots of things that don't go along with the university. With the university side of things, in terms of at the university level, the kids are a little bit older. They've been through the grind of riding the buses for hours and all that. And I think the university levels, it's getting better and better every year. Almost turned into a semi-pro hockey league now. You look at some of the kids that are coming back from pro hockey and realizing how good university hockey is.
Jim, when these kids are starting out Major A at 15, 16, 17 years old, I guess they're starting it up there at 17, but a big adjustment. What's the biggest adjustment? Just the fact that they're moving away from home?
Yeah, I think in terms of the off ice, it's moving into a billet family, getting accustomed to, the family values of their billet family and going into a new school that they really know nobody. Besides their teammates, I think we have 11 kids who go to high school right now, so they don't know anybody besides their 10 teammates, and it's a lifestyle change too. So there's the French kids, they do go to an English school here too, so it's a big change for them. And in terms of the hockey side, you get a 16-year-old, 17-year-old kid coming in, playing against kids that are older in minor hockey. They play with kids who are their age or a year younger, right? So that's one of the big adjustments, a 16-year-old kid coming and playing against, a 19, 20-year-old too, in terms of physical strength and speed and things like that on the hockey side.
If there's an analogy being made between the Halifax Mooseheads and the Edmonton Oilers, is that they're both at the same kind of place in their development, obviously on two different levels. The Oilers have all these great draft picks, and they're going to be a great team. The Halifax Mooseheads have all these great draft picks. I know it's been a tough few years, but there must be a lot of excitement in Halifax.
Yeah, there is, definitely. And that was sort of the exciting part of our coaching staff coming in is there was all the talk all summer about us trying to acquire Nathan MacKinnon, and it came down to us getting him and our young goalie Zachary Fucali, who's been outstanding for us. He's a 16-year-old kid who's really took the ball with Anthony Terenzio being out with a concussion. So in terms of 16-year-old kids coming in, Ryan Falkingham was just named to Team Atlantic last weekend. So, you know, there's the youth movement is really exciting. I guess I never really thought about the Edmonton Oilers, but you're bang on with some of the young kids and some prospects. And Marty Frick will be back in the lineup next weekend, so we're really excited to sort of get one of our top players back and to play alongside Nathan MacKinnon.
And, Jim, there's a young player, I think, correct me if I'm wrong, second-round draft pick that decided to stay in Quebec to play AAA midget. He'll arrive next year. Am I right about that?
Yes, Jonathan Drouin was actually the second overall pick, and you know, we're still in communicating with his family, and Jonathan's got to make that decision whether he wants to come to the Mooseheads or not. I know he's exploring the NCAA route, and I know he's down to see five universities a few weeks ago, and he's been here to Halifax to see what we have to offer too. So he's looking at all his options, and I know Bobby Smith and Cam Russell are in constant contact with his family and Jonathan and obviously his agent as well. So we'd love to have him, but Jonathan's ultimately got to make that decision if he wants to be a Halifax Moosehead.
You mentioned the name Nathan MacKinnon the other day. Certainly there's been a lot of media hype about this young fellow being from Cole Harbour, the same home community as Sidney Crosby. So give us the real scouting report. Is this kid the real deal?
Yeah, you know, I said it to a local paper last, the St. John paper, when I was in town there 2 weeks ago, and you almost feel a little feel a little bad for him because there's so much comparison to him to Sidney Crosby in terms of being from Cole Harbour and going to Shattuck St. Mary's and wearing Sid's number down there too. So he is the real deal. You know, I had a chance to work with Sid when he was that age, and you know, during some spring hockey stuff, and Nathan's right up there against him. And there's only one Sidney Crosby, and there's only one Nathan MacKinnon, and that's really been Nathan's focus, is just to be himself and do what he does best. And you know, but he's an outstanding player. If you get a chance to come in and watch him, I'm telling you, he's gonna bring you out of your seat, and he makes something happen every time he's on the ice.
You guys start your season in September, so you're pretty much mid-season here, Jim. And there's been a lot of talk that maybe the Mooseheads are a contending team this year. Is that something that's realistic?
Yeah, you know, I think we're a little bit ahead of where we thought we were going to be, and you know, we've been fortunate to I guess battle through some of the injuries we've had. We've had four or five kids out with concussions, and Andrew Ryan, who's supposed to be a top, expected to be a top pick in the National Hockey League, has just come back and played his first four games of the year off of a broken ankle. So we really can't give ourselves a fair assessment yet because we haven't had our whole lineup back. We've had Marty Frick out since September 1st with concussion, and hopefully we'll get him back next weekend. So we're excited, and you know, we're happy where we're at, and hats off to the kids because it's all about the kids, and they've really bought into you know, I guess our philosophy and concepts that we've tried to implement with the team. So we're happy where we are, and you know, it's an exciting time for us, and the kids are, you know, they're hard working at practice, and they're really happy where we're at.
Well, Jim, we're winding up the first half of the university season here tonight, St. Mary's and Acadia, and of course, both those teams very familiar to you, both coaches very familiar to you. Obviously, for you, some great memories of as a player and as a coach.
Yeah, you know, I come out in 1998, and I haven't left the Maritimes yet. So, Trevor Steinberg and Darren Burns have done a lot for me as a player and as a person, and obviously with my coaching career, they're two guys I've always been able to lean on for advice and to lean on for any coaching situation or anything that I've had to deal with hockey and life things. So they're two people that I have a lot of respect for, and they've done a lot for me, as I said, for my life and hockey career. So they're two guys I can lean on, that's for sure.
Jim, very, very happy for you that you're with the Mooseheads, and certainly one of these days we're going to see your name as a head coach somewhere. All the best to you this year, and we'll look forward to getting up over the Christmas break to see the Mooseheads.
Thanks for having me, Lenny.
Jim Midgley tonight, an assistant coach with the Halifax Mooseheads. Scoreboard summary and the third period. Next, you're listening to the Leon's Furniture March of Champions on ABR.
What Christmas carol is a favorite of parents of a newborn? Silent Night. Yes, Leon's Ho Ho Hold the Payments event is on now, and it just got better. Right now, you can get a gorgeous platform bed with leather-like headboard for only $5.99. And you can pay absolutely nothing, not even the taxes, for 18 months with no interest. Leon's Ho Ho Hold the Payments event. Now even better. Merry Christmas, Canada.
Light up your holiday spirit December 4th in Wolfville with the return of Christmas with Friends. Host Rachel McLean welcomes ECMA great Terry Kelly and Cape Breton fiddling sensation Wendy McIsaac. Tickets for Christmas with Friends are available at CVZ and PharmaSave locations in the Valley and at the Acadia box office. Christmas with Friends at University Hall, Wolfville, Sunday, December 4th at 7 p.m. Presented by Atlantic CVZ, PharmaSave, and AVR.
AVR's review of 2011.
January.
On January the 16th, The Social Network was the big winner at the Golden Globes. It took away four awards, including the Best Dramatic Movie. The following night, January the 17th, Piers Morgan debuted on CNN. His first guest on his first show was Oprah. The guest the following night was Howard Stern.
Even though I'm ranting and raving like a lunatic for your show. And as far as Oprah goes, I'm happy that Oprah makes a living.
On January 31st, it was announced that you too would perform in Moncton July 30th.
2011 in review on AVR. The Leon's Furniture March of Champions presents On the Scoreboard. Brought to you by Berwick Building Supplies. We try harder.
Good evening, I'm Amanda Meisner on the scoreboard tonight. Atlantic University Sport Hockey. UNB leading St. Thomas 2-1 after 2. Moncton leads UPEI 2-1 after 2 periods of play. Nova Scotia Junior Hockey League. The East Hants Penguins playing the Royals tonight in Windsor. NHL play, just one Canadian team in action. Columbus is in Edmonton tonight at 10:30.
On the scoreboard. Now, you know the score.
Ladies, the best Christmas party of the season is at Berwick Building Supplies. You heard right, the annual Girls Tax-Free Shopping Party is this Thursday evening. Find something for everyone on your list, from tools to boutique-inspired decor items, all tax-free. Enjoy truffles and coffee from Kate's Pantry, and representatives from Leah Sophia Jewelry and Watkins will be there. So invite the girls out for tax-free shopping. The first 40 shoppers will receive a gift. The Girls Shopping Party, Thursday, 7 to 9 at Berwick Building Supplies. We try harder.
The Leon's Furniture March of Champions presents Scoreboard Summary. Brought to you by McKay Real Estate, Main Street, Wolfville.
Has the economic news got you worried? Hi, I'm John McKay of McKay Real Estate. The Valley has proven to be a safe haven. If you're thinking of buying or selling a home, call our experienced McKay Real Estate agents in Windsor or Wolfville and let us guide you through the process. We've been helping families make their dreams come true for 40 years. Visit us today at mckayrealestate.com.
Go, Axemen, go. McKay Real Estate is proud to be part of the March of Champions on AVR.
Welcome back to Acadia Arena in Wolfville. No scoring in the second period. St. Mary's will go to the third period with a 2-1 lead over the Acadia Axemen. Shots in the second period, 10 for Acadia, 9 for St. Mary's in the game. Acadia outshooting SMU 15-14. St. Mary's 1-for-3 with a man advantage tonight. Acadia is 0-for-3. The Axemen coming into this game tied with St. Mary's for second place, each team with 19 points, although the Axemen will have a game in hand on St. Mary's. This is game number 15 of the season for Acadia. They'll play 13 games after Christmas. This is game number 16 for St. Mary's, and they will play just 12 games in the second half. Well, you heard earlier tonight, Bruce Beaton here with Little Athletes, Big Leaders. We're going to give you a chance right now to win his book, Little Athletes, Big Leaders. If you are the first caller to Amanda, 1-800-565-5113. That'll be a nice Christmas gift for you. It's a great read. Bruce Beaton, Little Athletes, Big Leaders. Call Amanda right now, 1-800-565-5113. Both teams coming onto the ice here to get ready for period number 3. And both teams will open up the third period at full strength. And Travis, we know how this game is unfolded. So what are the thoughts in terms of what has to happen here in the third period to pull out a win over the Huskies?
Well, I mean, I think, you know, you just kind of have to, you know, in a way, forget about the first 40 minutes and just, realize you're down a goal and, you know, have a great opportunity with a good 20 minutes to come out and, you know, get a big 2 points. I think, you know, there's no sense really in dwelling on all the negatives that have taken place in the first two periods. You just got to, you know, come out and try to, you know, lay it all out and play a good solid 20 minutes.
Well, we've got three games in the conference going on tonight. All three games are 2-1 scores after two periods of play. UMB leading St. Thomas, Moncton leading BEI, and of course St. Mary's leading Acadia. And here we go. The puck into the St. Mary's zone. D'Orazio sends it ahead, and quickly Pridham is going to carry it to the Axemen line. Let the shot go low and wide. And Gibbons with the puck works it over to Clark, who lifts it high in the air through the middle. Bounces at the St. Mary's line. And the Huskies get it outside the line. Bloodoff is there and takes a bump from Clark. Owens whips it ahead to Beaton. Beaton puts the brace on, left wing boards, dumps it down to the corner for Helas. Helas digs it free for Clark, but he couldn't get a return pass. D'Orazio sends to the middle. Bloodoff almost sent in all alone. Bloodoff fires it cross ice. His teammates changing up, so he was all alone. The Axemen up the ice, and Beaton's going to lift it in. And the Axemen are going to change up here. Almost a minute played in the third period. St. Mary's 2, Acadia 1. Puck down to the Axemen net. Mosier fires it ahead to Schwinnard, who's forced to backtrack, and now he'll give it to Ward behind the Acadia net. To Kraseva, and he tried to send it ahead, but it went off a stick over the glass. And the faceoff will move outside the Acadia line. A reminder, the Axemen will host an exhibition game here December the 30th against the St. Thomas Tommies. January 2nd, the Axemen will take on St. Evex at the King's Mutual Century Center, the Apple Dome in Berwick. Get tickets from minor hockey members and Scotiabank locations in the western end of the valley. Teams will have to work off some of that Christmas turkey. Looks like they've already been into the turkey here the way this game has been played. 2-1 St. Mary's, puck in the Axemen zone. LeBears just gets out of the way of a hit, gives it to Schwinnard, and he works it deep into the St. Mary's zone. Cuthbert to it first, tried to play it by Jezegu. Puck on the near side, kept in. Schwinnard shoots low and wide. Wallingford behind the net. And the defenseman on the far side had it taken away by Jezegu. Jezegu walks toward the net, and then he misfired on the pass. He ran out of real estate down there. Casey Brown in the corner, trying to chop it by Wallingford, and he does. Jezegu with a pass in front of the net, and he missed Gaynor. Husky's going to bank it off the boards down the ice, and icing is called against the St. Mary's Huskies. So the Axemen with a good forecheck there, trying to create something. 2:09 gone here in the third period, and the faceoff will move into the St. Mary's zone. Faceoff in the SMU zone. It'll be Clark on the draw. He has Acadia's only goal. Huskies win the draw. Wallingford, in behind the net, lifts it over the glass and out of play. He'll get a whistle, and the Huskies will be able to change up. He was playing in the NHL. He'd be heading to the penalty box right now.
Yeah, I mean, that's a rule. I mean, you know, there's times when you'd like to see that called. I mean, obviously there, he's you know, he's shooting the puck out of play. I mean, I know in some rinks, obviously, the glass is a little shorter, and that's why we don't have that rule in our league. But, I mean, there's times where you'd like to think, you know, if you had referee's discretion that you could, you know, after an icing where it's obvious that a guy's just trying to get that whistle to get the change, that you could make that call.
Yeah, he made it very clear what his intentions were. Puck down below the Acadia goal line, tip-off on the left wing boards, forced to play it in behind the net. After there, Smith looking out front, centering pass for Fergus, who is tied up by Owens in the crease. Play moves to the corner. Tip-off pinned up by Owens. Helas trying to dig it free. Fergus does. Plays it out to Smith, and he moves it into the corner. And that's where the play has been. Smith on the right wing board sends it toward the net, and it went off Owens and Beaton with a left wing pass to Clark. Clark in over the line, and he's poke-checked there, and Smith takes over for St. Mary's. 3 minutes and 15 seconds played here in the third period with St. Mary's leading 2-1. Pass ahead for Eckelman. He'll bring it in on the left side as the Axemen change up. Shot steered away by Peters. Gaynor on the far side. Couldn't keep it in. And Fergus moves to center, and now he'll bounce it in around the boards. Mosier steers it to the corner for Ward. and it's turned over, and then Gaynor back to help the defense. Pushes this man along the boards into the corner. Gaynor tying him up on the far side. Dominguez, and now it's dug free by Ward. Dominguez played it behind the net, and Gaynor is there. Around the net. Gaynor takes a hit, plays it out to center. Carmichael cut it off, and now the Huskies will wrap it off the glass, and it goes high in the air outside the line. Grant ahead to Carmichael, who sends it into the Axemen zone. Ward behind the net, taking his time, waiting for everybody to set up. Pridham is right in front of the Acadia net, watching the Acadia defenseman, who plays it off the boards out to center. Eckelman tried to play it through the middle. Now he gets it ahead to Schwinnard. Gets it in over the line. Bloodoff takes a hit from Lemaire's, and it was a hard one. And Bloodoff gets up slowly. Puck centered, and Ward couldn't handle it. And the puck comes out to center, and Jezegu is there. Jezegu. And then he's cross-checked by Bloodoff. No penalty call. Bloodoff was upset after taking the hit a few minutes ago, and now Kursiva hits him along the boards. Lemaire's fires a pass, and it hit Pridham, and he felt that one. Now Lemaire's gets it ahead to Schwinnard. Schwinnard into the St. Mary's zone and takes a one-hander on the skates. No penalty call from the referee. Tanaka playing it into the Acadia zone. Schwinnard bumping with Tanaka. Tanaka behind the net, looks out front. Centering pass. McKinnon shoots. Stopped by Mosier. And he's quick to cover up on the rebound. A host of penalties could have been called in the last 35 seconds. And the referee's just letting her go.
Yeah, I mean, I think, you know, he probably could have called the hit on Lemaire's there, and then, you know, Bludoff just comes and, you know, no mistaking what he was doing there. He was a little upset about the hit and came with a cross check, and then there's a couple flashes on both sides that weren't called there. So, I mean, it looks like there's, you know, going to be free reign here in the third to do as you will out there.
So I guess the referee says these two teams are taking the night off. I'll take the night off, too, and just add to it. Helis with a shot. Stop by Peters, puck to the point, and it comes outside, and Owens backs up, giving it to Gibbons inside the Acadia line. Over to Owens, a little bit of room on the right side, fires it ahead off the skate of Beaton. He'll track it down in the corner. Beaton steers it around on the near side. Strickland is there, chops at it, not out. Owens will flick it, but a little too high over the glass and out of play. 2-1 SMU, 6 minutes into the third period. Leon's Furniture March of Champions on EBR.
This portion of the Leon's Furniture March of Champions is brought to you by Holland Home Leisure, New Minas and Aylesford. Why wait? Live life now.
14:07 on the clock. 2-1 is the score favoring the St. Mary's Huskies. All the scoring in the first period, with the lowest amount of shots, 5 each side of that period, and since then the goaltenders have been solid. Bona up the left side, ran into Smith, plays scrambly here, and now Fergus will lift it into the left wing corner. Tip off, plays it behind the net. Fergus centers on it, quickly tip off, and he's forced back to the blue line, works to the boards, and dumps it in behind the net for Smith. Smith with a wraparound attempt, and it's stopped. Puck back to the blue line, kept in by the Huskies. Now it's knocked out. Good job by Gurman, who is right there, pinned up against Deegan. Huskies will play it in behind the Acadia net, and on it there is Bona. Fires it around the boards, out to center. Helis tipped it through the middle. Getting to it first is O'Keefe, and then he took a hit from Brown. Huskies once again dumping it into the Axemen zone. Dominguez takes a hit from Warren in the corner. Around the boards, kept in by the Huskies. Ward pinning up his man. McElrath for Acadia, looking for the loose puck. Won't get it. Now does. Banks it outside the line. D'Orazio sends it right back in. Kursiva around the boards. Ward will play it up on the left side. Too far for Eckelman. Huskies dumping it right back in. 12:40 to go here in the third. St. Mary's with a 2-1 lead. Kursiva fires it pass up on the right side. Helis banks it on the boards, and McElrath had it go off the end of his stick. D'Orazio and McElrath go to the boards. Eckelman on the far side, tied up by Dominguez. Now the loose puck taken by McElrath into the right wing corner. McElrath takes a bump. Puck is fired around, and it gets by Owens and slides into the Axemen zone. Owens plays it ahead to Helis on the left side. Helis banks it on the boards by Wallingford. Down to the goal line. Helis behind the net. Around on the right side. Helis will leave it down in the corner. It's turned over and the Huskies break out. Play on the near side and Pridham will carry it in on the right side. Banks it toward the net. Then took a big hit from Helis. And Pridham gets up slowly and the Axemen are going to move out. Owens on the right side. Gibbon, wrist shot, glove save. Peters, and he hangs on. Yeah, we'll get a face-off, a little bit of trash talk in around the St. Mary's net. 11:43 to go, and the trend continues here with not a lot of shots on goal. The Axemen here in the third with two shots, and the Huskies with just one shot here in the third period. Off the faceoff, Jezegu to Gibbons, right point, shoots toward the net, stopped by Peters, and he hangs on. I thought in the second period when the Axemen had 10 shots that Peters was allowing some juicy rebounds. We just weren't getting to them in time.
Yeah, I mean, I thought early on he was, you know, as you said, he was giving up a lot of rebounds. I think in that last, you know, I think it started almost on that power play we had towards the end of the second, and, you know, he's carried it on, and his rebound control has been a lot better here in the last, 15 minutes of this game.
St. Mary's call for icing here, so faceoff will come back with 11:32 to go in the third period. Well, the winner of this game will take sole possession of second place, maybe even tie with UMB for first, depending on what happens at the Aiken Center tonight. UMB at last report leading Stu 2-1. Puck in the corner, Schwinnard out to LeBears, off his stick to the corner. Jezegu gives it to LeBears behind the net. LeBears looking out front. LeBears forced to dump it into the corner. On it there is Schwinnard. Banks it off the backboards. Owens has it on the right wing boards. Fires it cross ice for Schwinnard. Takes a shot off a leg into the far corner. McKinnon going after it. Chips it on the boards and it bounces up on the left side. Strickland going after the loose puck. Battling with Schwinnard and a good battle there between the two players. And Schwinnard wins that battle and the Axemen come out. Jezegu with a pass through the middle, bounces around, on it, quickly Owens, and ahead of the play, Jezegu offside, just when it looked like St. Mary's had a little bit, Owens had a little bit of open ice on that far side, Jezegu was a step inside the blue line, and the bouncing puck led, or contributed to that offside, as Owens tried to gather it up. We're going to get a penalty here, and it's going to be Schwinnard for Acadia that's going to the box. And so the Huskies get their fourth power play of the night. 1-for-3 so far. And a somewhat pivotal point here in the third period. With the Axemen down a goal, they'll need to kill this one off. Off the faceoff, Pridham playing it behind the net. Tanaka gives it to McKinnon. Banks it on the boards, but Gaynor is there to break it up, and Gaynor plays it through the middle, and Helis, top of the St. Mary's line, bats at it to get it into the St. Mary's zone, and D'Orazio has it. Pass on the right side to Fergus, always dangerous, along the blue line, plays it over to Tanaka, leaves it at the point, Pridham to Fergus. Fergus pinned up on the far side by Gaynor. Now the puck pushed free by Ward, in behind the Acadian at Tanaka. Gives it to Fergus. Ward all over him. Fergus down low to Tanaka. Left wing corner. Plays it to the point. D'Orazio to McKinnon. Right wing boards. McKinnon fires it cross ice. Pridham has it. Centers it. And it went off a stick and bounces out to center. D'Orazio playing it ahead to McKinnon. Axemen changing up the penalty killers. Ward chops the puck out. Here come the Axemen out of the zone. Clark with the left wing pass to Beaton. Three Axemen in. Goes cross ice. One-timer stopped by Peters as he went across the crease. Owens got that shot away. Huskies out to center. And the puck brought in by Pridham. Fires across ice. Gibbons breaks it up and then passes outside the line. Owens is going to pick it up and bring in a rolling puck. Owens in, shoots low and wide. And a penalty coming up here against the Acadia Axemen, I believe. An interference call is going to be handed out here to Acadia. And Darren Burns not happy. Andrew Clark says something to the referee, and it's going to be beaten. And the fans giving it to the official here right now. So St. Mary's will have a two-man advantage for 29 seconds. That's when Schwinnard is scheduled to come out of the box. 9:16 to play in the third period. SMU 2, Acadia 1. And St. Mary's is going to call a timeout, and we'll take a quick little break. You're listening to the Leon's Furniture March of Champions on ABR.
This portion of the Leon's Furniture March of Champions is brought to you by Valley Ford Kentville. Where else?
Welcome back to Acadia. I want to say hi to Cindy Greeno in Canning. She was the correct caller and wins Bruce Beaton's new book. And that's entitled Little Athletes, Big Leaders. Cindy, thanks for listening to the game. Congratulations. 9:16 remaining in the third period. 19:15 are the shots on goal favoring the Axemen, but it's St. Mary's with a 2-1 lead on the scoreboard. Huskies coming off a big come-from-behind victory over St. Evex Wednesday night at the Halifax Forum. And the Axemen trying to rebound after losing to St. Evex on Sunday. Face off in the Acadia zone. Gaynor and Fergus on the draw. And the puck comes to McKinnon on the right wing boards. He'll send it left point to D'Orazio. Fakes the shot, plays it down low to Fergus. Out front to McKinnon. Over to Tanaka, right wing circle. Out to McKinnon. To Tanaka, back in the circle. Back to McKinnon. Cross ice, D'Orazio fires it. Stop front, rebound, stop. Knocked away by Owens as it was falling toward the blue paint. D'Orazio to McKinnon. Winds up, fakes the shot. McKinnon fires it over. Tanaka misfires on the shot. Owens into the corner. Hugs the puck along the board. Schwinnard is out of the box, so it's now a 5-on-4 power play for St. Mary's. Leading by a goal. All the play in the corner. Five or six players in there, and now we get a whistle. So the Axemen survive the initial scare, but it's not over yet. A minute 19 to go. The Axemen there, Travis, did a really good job of not allowing McKinnon or Tanaka to get shots.
Yeah, I mean, a good job of getting pressure up on the two defensemen and not giving them time to really, you know, set that one-timer up. And, you know, when they did get it to the net, Mosier made a great save and then, a real good play by Owens in front just to bat that puck out of harm's way.
Play underway, puck in the corner, Gibbons digging it free. Owens takes a hit. Now Gibbons around the net, has a little bit of room on the right side. Gibbons sends a pass to the middle for Helas, who comes in, winds up, shoots and fired it wide. And then it deflected up and came down. Helas took it away from his man, and Helas sends it back to Owens at the left point. It's the Axemen shorthanded, but they're the ones controlling things. Long shot that Peter stops. And the goaltender's going to hang on to it here. So a good job by Helas and Owens. 50 seconds now remaining in the penalty to Alex Beaton. 8:06 to go in the third period. The Axemen just want to kill this off and look for a way to generate something around that St. Mary's net. Gaynor will take the faceoff, and off the draw, Axemen control. And Ward has it on the near boards, and then lost the handle on the puck, and now the Huskies get out, but Gaynor hustles back to break it up. Huskies go get the puck back. Smith, and then he turned it over to Gaynor, who plays it out to center. Wallingford with it. Slaps the puck into the far corner. Strickland plays it around the boards. Tip off, back to Wallingford. Sends it down low to Smith. Smith in the right wing corner. Gives it to tip off along the boards. Down to Smith. Smith pushed to the boards by Ward. Tip off comes in, takes the loose puck, centers off a skate. And Gaynor sends it ahead to Schwinnard. Schwinnard in a foot race with his man. And he's not going to win it, if you can believe that. So he backtracks and plays it all the way back into his own end. And Owen slaps it down the ice. So the penalty is over. Schwinnard hits his man into the corner. And the Axemen down by a goal, back to full strength. Huskies control deep in their own zone. Dumbosch sends it ahead. D'Orazio takes a pass to the right side. Slaps one high at Mosier, steers to the corner. Puck behind the net. Owens knocked off by Bloodoff. Bloodoff controlling in the corner. Gives it to O'Donnell. O'Donnell has Owens all over him from behind. 6:42 to go in the third. St. Mary's protecting a 2-1 lead. Bloodoff knocked to the ice by Andrew Clark. who does a good job. Bona throwing his weight around along the boards in tight. Blunoff tries to come out in front, knocked to the ice again. Helis chips it on the boards. Here come the Axemen, four of them out to center. Lead pass to Clark. Clark looks to shoot, lets it go, and Peters the stop. And he hangs on. So they get a face-off in the St. Mary's zone. There's not been many odd man rushes here tonight. The Axemen got one there, and I guess the guy you want shooting is the guy to let it go, Travis.
Absolutely. I mean, a good job there in the defensive zone by Clark and Owens down low, and, you know, then a good quick transition and, you know, a pretty good opportunity there coming, you know, off that two-on-one.
Face off in the SMU zone. LeBears on the draw. Trying to get it to Eckelman. It went off a stick. Huskies with a chance to clear, and they get it out to center. And now it bounces into the Acadia zone. Mosier slaps it into the corner. Oh, and Fergus just took a hit from behind from Kursiva. And there's going to be a penalty here to the Axemen defenseman. Fergus getting up slowly. Puck comes to the near side. Tip off. Gives it to McKinnon back at the point. Tip off has it right wing boards. Gives it to McKinnon. And now the whistle blows. And we're going to get a checking from behind penalty here for Kursiva. With 5:48 remaining in the third period. Now we'll see what he dishes out here. And it's going to be 2 minutes and a 10, I believe. So the Axemen with 5:48 remaining, trailing 2-1, forced to kill another penalty here. Faceoff will be to the right of Evan Mosier. Despite giving up the two goals in the first period, has been solid. He made some big stops late in the second period. So Casey Brown will come over to serve the minor. Kasiba will the 10-minute misconduct go along with that. Won't see the rest of regulation time. His only hope now is that this game gets into overtime. The Axemen need to score one, but they're down a man now and have to kill off another one. Fergus out to take the faceoff against Gaynor. Puck goes to the point. D'Orazio along the blue line. Gives it to McKinnon. Back to D'Orazio. Quick shot. Stop. The rebound. Edge of the crease. Fergus centers out in front. D'Orazio winds. Scores. And St. Mary's with a 3-1 lead on the slap shot by D'Orazio. And the Huskies score their second power play goal of the night at 14:26. And the Axemen, who have been hard-pressed to generate some good quality scoring opportunities, now really have to dig deep with 5:34 on the clock. And for D'Orazio, his third of the season at 14:26. Now that makes it a 3-1 game. Off the face-off, Axemen control. Bona in his own end. Gives it to Ward, and Ward looking ahead. Huskies, five of them back, not giving the Axemen any room. Helis to Clark. Return pass to Helis. Centers in front. Shot. Scores! Alex Beaton put it underneath the goaltender at the edge of the crease. Some fans were leaving the building, and they stopped over at the blue doors. And the Axemen here get right back in it. And it'll be Alex Beaton that gets the goal. And it'll be his sixth of the season. And it comes at 14:45, and it took the Axemen just 19 seconds to get back to within one. So now it's a 3-2 hockey game. Hang on. Bona gives it to Ward. Back to Bona, and he comes out of the Axemen zone with a pass that deflects over the St. Mary's line. Puck bouncing around at center. McKinnon has it. Plays it back to Umbosch, and he'll play it through the middle, brought in by McKinnon. And Helis now deep in the Axemen zone. Under 5 minutes to play in the third. It's a 3-2 hockey game. Helis comes around on the left side. Helis on the boards. Kicks it down low and out of the goaltender. Peters to steer it to the boards. And the Huskies get it outside the line, and it bounces to the Axemen line, and Ward gives it to Bona. And Bona played it off the backboards. It came out toward the crease, and Mosier, fortunately, was alert in there. LeBears gives it to Bona. turns it over, and here comes Tanaka looking in front of the goal. Tanaka to the backhander, and it goes wide, and now after it is Jezegu. Jezegu out with a left wing pass to German. German over the St. Mary's line. German centering it, deflects in front as LeBears was going to the net. Shot it away, stopped by Peters. And now we're going to get a host of players going at it behind the net. Sticks and gloves flying everywhere, and tempers fly here. Jezegu has a hold of his man down behind the St. Mary's net, and they fall on the back of the net to the ice. And everybody seems to be getting split up here with 4:02 on the clock. And the Axemen came ever so close to tying this hockey game. Don't go away. This one's not over yet. Jezegu's going to go to the penalty box, and German's already there. And the Huskies will have some players going in there. O'Keefe is going to go to the box for St. Mary's. And Deegan's going to go in there. So the Axemen and Huskies will hope this all offsets. 3-2. St. Mary's went ahead 3-1 on a power play goal by D'Orazio. But the Axemen came right back 19 seconds later, beating his sixth of the season, tucking it underneath the goaltender Peters in close at 14:45, and that was an even-strength goal to make it 3-2. LeBears and Fergus, the two veteran forwards, out talking with the referee at center. And so far, nothing is up on the penalty clock, so we'll have to assume the four players in the box are all getting offsetting minors here. And the faceoff will be in the St. Mary's zone. And now we get a lot of yelling at the St. Mary's bench. They're saying the faceoff should be outside the line. The referee's not going to have anything to do with it. Clark's going to take the draw. And it's won by St. Mary's in the corner. Cuthbert gets it behind the net to Wallingford. Chips it on the glass to the point. Bounces by Owens. And now quickly on a tip-off. He has a man go to the net. Tip-off looking in front. Shoot! And it went wide around the boards. Kept in by Cuthbert. Fergus dumping it down to tip off behind the net. Centers in front, knocked away. Back to the point, Cuthbert plays it around the boards. Smith lets it go by. Puck centered out in front. Backhand by Fergus, stopped by Mosier. Fergus, another shot, and it deflects wide, and Beaton's going to pick it up. 3:25 to go in the third. St. Mary's up 3-2. Cuthbert off the boards. He'll work it ahead to Smith. Smith took a hit. Now the puck ahead to Fergus. Slowly in over the line, and he's just going to play it behind the Acadia net. Swept away by Mosier. Kept in by the Huskies. Tip off in the corner. Bumping with Bona. Now Owens has it on the near side. Owens through the middle. It was behind everybody. Dumbosch has to go back for it quickly. And he put himself into the corner. And then he was hit. Centering pass. Great save. Peters off. Eckelman, who was parked in front of the goal. And then D'Orazio just took a big hit from Eckelman behind the net and gets up slowly. Puck bounces back at the Acadia line, and on it is LeBears, giving it to Bona. Bona around the net. Sends it ahead to Eckelman, went off him, and after it is Casey Brown. He couldn't get into the slot. He was trying to work there. And now the Huskies clear it out, and it goes into the Axemen zone. 2:23 remaining in the third with the Huskies up a goal. Ward coming out of the zone. Blew a tire, and he's forced to wrist it around the boards. Peters behind his goal. Turns it over. Ward centers in front. Backhander. Great save, Peters, who got back and stopped it with the pad. The best hockey of the game just in the last 5 minutes. They waited 55 minutes to get at it here. Owens coming out of the Axemen zone, under 2 minutes to play. Owens gets to center, wristing it down. Peters is going to glove it, and he's going to shoot it ahead himself. Tanaka works it ahead out to center. On it quickly, Grant scores! What a shot by Grant! 2 or 3 feet inside the blue line, and he beat Mosier on the glove side up high. And the Huskies have a 4-2 lead at 18-16. And Evan Mosier would like to have that one back. So the SMU Huskies get their two-goal lead back. And Grant is the guy that took that pass And he rifled a shot by the goaltender. And it's 4-2. Beaton brings the puck in on the right side. We'll watch the Acadia goaltender to see if he heads off for the extra attacker. Puck bouncing around. Huskies are going to come out. Fergus has it at center. And he dumps it in. Mosier the stop. Clark on the far side. Battling there with Fergus. Gibbons digging it free. And then the puck taken away by Fergus. And Fergus gets it back into the zone, battling with Owens. A minute 13 to go in the third period. Play in the corner. Smith tied up by Clark. And now Gibbons the loose puck, and for sure Evan Mosier will go to the bench now. Puck through the middle. Helas took it in his skates, couldn't hang on to it. And now an empty net, and it's going to be fired wide by Tipoff. Pridham shoots, and it deflects off a leg. Another shot off a stick behind the goal. Schwinnard, 46 seconds to go. Penalty coming up to St. Mary's. Beaton has the puck in over the line. Drops it to Schwinnard. He can't shoot. And finally the whistle blows. And now Schwinnard and the goaltender get into it. And the defenseman comes in and whacks him. And now everybody's getting into it on the ice. Tempers are flying here. I don't know what happened between Schwinnard and Peters, but they decided to get at it. And then a Husky jumped in there. St. Mary's was going to get a penalty. So I don't know how this will all unfold. And Schwinnard has something to say to Peters going behind the net now. And now defenseman for St. Mary's comes over, and they're all going to start gathering once again after they've been separated. So it's been a penalty parade to the box here in the last few minutes. 37 seconds to go in the third period. The Axemen are down by 2 goals. And now the referee is over to dish out more penalties here. Acadia was initially going to, or rather St. Mary's was getting the initial penalty as Schwinnard was taken down coming out of his own end. And then the Axemen went down the ice and they were trying to get a shot on goal. It really kind of turned into a 3-on-1. And then after the whistle blew, Schwinnard and the goaltender Peters kind of get into it. And as they were doing that, another Huskies player came flying out of nowhere to hit Schwinnard, and that brought everybody together. So right now they're showing a 2-minute minor up on the clock for St. Mary's. And at this point, they've got the faceoff outside the St. Mary's blue line. So the Axemen will keep the goaltender on the bench and have a 6-on-4 skating advantage. Now I think Darren Burns is going to call a timeout, and he does. We'll take a quick little breather here. You're listening to the Leon's Furniture March of Champions on AVR.
Listen to the Leon's Furniture March of Champions online at avrnetwork.com. Exciting Acadia Axemen hockey. avrnetwork.com.
37.2 seconds remaining. This is where you wish the game was 4 periods long, because it's been pretty exciting the last 5 or 6 minutes after a not-so-exciting first 45, 50 minutes of this hockey game. 22-20 are the shots on goal favoring Acadia. But a big slap shot that beat Evan Mosier to put St. Mary's up 4-2, and it's a hole to dig out of here for Acadia. Goaltenders on the bench. And the Axemen are going to have 6 skaters to the St. Mary's 4 skaters. Face off outside the line. Clark is going to be waved out. LaBerge is going to come in to take the draw. And the puck is into the St. Mary's zone. Back forward Wallingford. Jumping it around the board. It gets by Helix and down the ice. And no ice. Now Ward and Wallingford back behind the play, having words with each other. And Beaton decides to come in and say something. Linesman gets in the way. Puck fired at the Acadia net. Tanaka has it. And his shot deflects over the glass, out of play with 13 seconds remaining. And so the Axemen here down by 2 goals. Even though they have a power play, it's going to be a moot point. Ward and Wallingford still having words with each other. So this game has worn on, really taking on a nasty tone. I mentioned it in the second period, and here in the third it has again. Right now there's four St. Mary's Huskies in their penalty box, four in the Axemen penalty box. Off the faceoff, puck comes to the near boards. Gaynor will work it to the corner. Bona sends it back to Owens. And Owens just going to skate behind the net and let the clock run out here, because there's just no time. The Acadia Axemen, after winning six straight, have now lost two straight to end the first half before the Christmas break. And we'll come back with the postgame show next. The Huskies win it 4-2 in Wolfville. You're listening to the Leon's Furniture March of Champions on ABR.
Where does Santa practice sliding down chimneys? The gymnasium.
Ho, ho, ho.
Yes, Leon's Ho, Ho, Hold the Payments event is on now, and it just got better. Right now, you can get a comfy reclining sofa for just $299 when you purchase a matching love seat and chair, and deliveries included. And you can pay absolutely nothing, not even the taxes, for 18 months with no interest. Leon's Ho, Ho, Hold the Payments event. Now even better. Merry Christmas, Canada.
Spend the holidays in hot water. Holland Home Leisure presents their 2011 Hot Tub Clear Out. Score a sweet deal on a new beachcomber, the energy-efficient hot tub that's made in Canada for our Canadian climate. On top of huge discounts, you'll receive a bonus prepaid Visa valued at up to $1,000, plus half-price hot tub accessories, stress relief, and prepaid plastic. Just in time for the holidays. Sail on now at Holland Home Leisure, New Minas and Aylesford, because life's better when you're wet.
Add a festive touch to your Christmas celebrations with Rayfuse Home Hardware Building Center. Drop by for a great selection of decorations, from LED lights to Christmas ornaments, tree stands to tinsel. You'll find